Hello and good day, welcome to our YouTube channel God's Promises and Todays. Video will be Book of Psalms, Chapter 69. Let's get started now. Psalm 69 is a lament written by David, expressing his feelings of distress and desperation in the face of persecution and injustice. This psalm can be divided into two sections. In the first half, David cries out to God for help and deliverance, and in the second half, he calls on God to punish his enemies. David begins the psalm by describing his suffering, save me, O God, for the waters have come up to my neck. E sinking deep mire, where there is no fault, old, I have come into deep waters, and the floods eps over me, Psalm 69:1-2. He feels overwhelmed by his troubles and is in danger of being drowned by them. David then goes on to describe the cause of his distress, those who hate me without cause are more than the ears of my head, many are those who would destroy me, my enemies who accuse me falsely, Psalm 69:4. He is being persecuted unjustly, and his enemies are spreading lies about him. Despite his distress, David maintains his faith in God and trusts that he will eventually be delivered, but as for me, my prayer is to you, O Lord. Et acceptable to me, O God, in the abundance of your steadfast love, answer me, Psalm 69:13. David believes that God will answer his prayer and deliver him from his troubles. In the second half of the psalm, David calls on God to punish his enemies for their wrongdoing. He has that they receive the same punishment they have inflicted on him, let their table be a trap for them, a snare for their allies. Let their eyes be darkened so that they cannot see, and make their loins tremble continually, Psalm 69:22-23. David is not asking for revenge, rather, he believes that God is a just God who will punish the wicked. The teaching application of Psalm 69 is that we can bring all our troubles and difficulties to God in prayer, knowing that he is a God who cares about us and is able to help us. We can trust that he will eventually deliver us from our troubles, even if we have to go through difficult times first. Furthermore, when we are being unjustly persecuted, we can call on God to defend the US and ask for justice to be done. We can trust that God is a God of justice who will punish the wicked and reward the righteous. Finally, we can learn from David's example of maintaining his faith in God even in the face of great difficulties. Despite the overwhelming nature of his troubles, David never lost faith that God would eventually deliver him. We too can trust in God's goodness and faithfulness, even when things seem to be going wrong. Obrigado por nós. Por favor, compartilhe conosco seu capítulo bíblico favorito, abaixo na seção de comentários. Não se esqueça de curtir e se inscrever, isso realmente ajuda nosso canal a crescer. Espero vê-lo de volta aqui para o nosso próximo vídeo. Cuide-se sempre bem!